Today, we present to you some of the most toxic substances found on Earth. Number one is extremely dangerous, but deliberately taken in by millions of people worldwide. Number 9. Rhodium. Rhodium is a chemically inert metal of the platinum group that is extremely rare and valued as a precious metal. Due to its high value and resistance to corrosion, the element is usually alloyed with other precious metals to be served as a metal plating. White gold, for example, is often plated with a rhodium layer, giving it its beautiful shiny appearance. Although pure rhodium is chemically inactive, its chemical complexes can be reactive and harmful. At high levels, it is considered immediately lethal, and early symptoms of rhodium chemical poisoning include severe cough, eye redness, and itchy skin rashes. Workers in the jewelry manufacturing in particular can be exposed to the element through inhalation, causing a rather serious occupational hazard. Number 8. Ricin. Ricin is one of nature's deadliest substances that is found in plants instead of animals. It is a naturally occurring carbohydrate-binding protein that is produced in the beans of a castor oil plant. The toxic substance has the ability to inactivate and wreak havoc on ribosomes within our cells, resulting in impaired ability to further synthesize proteins. Just a mere 500 micrograms of ricin is enough to kill an adult human. To put that into perspective, that's about 1/2000 of the weight of a paperclip. Most cases of acute ricin poisoning are the result of ingestion of castor beans. However, unless the beans were thoroughly chewed, most people could survive the poisoning. Symptoms include nausea, watery diarrhea, tachycardia, hypotension, and seizures that usually last for days. Dangerous when inhaled, ingested, and injected in small amounts, ricin's potency and lethality has led to many countries studying its use as a biological weapon for the past century. The castor oil plant itself is a rather popular ornamental shrub, and the ease of extracting its toxin has made ricin a poison of choice for many assassins. In 1978, a Bulgarian communist defector working for the BBC was assassinated in the streets of London via a micro-engineered pellet containing ricin. The pellet was shot from an umbrella carried by an assassin believed to be working for the Bulgarian secret police. Number 7. Strychnine. Strychnine is an alkaloid found in the plants of the genus Strychnos, which are native to many tropical countries. However, the substance could now also be produced artificially in labs. Strychnine acts as a neurotoxin that primarily affects the motor nerves in the spinal cord. Exposure to it would cause a chemical in the nerves that regulates muscle contraction to be blocked, causing the muscles to be in a constant state of stimulation. A victim could be affected by strychnine by inhalation, ingestion, or even by absorbing it through the eyes. Once it enters the bloodstream, their muscles would contract violently, causing extreme agitation and a rather gruesomely agonizing death. Typically, there would be seizures, bulging of the eyes, and arching of the back, and within 30 minutes, the victim would be dead from asphyxia. Ruthless Nazi leader Oskar Dillwanger was known to inject young Jewish female prisoners with strychnine for entertainment, and watched as they writhed and twisted to death in front of him and his friends. It is also suggested that Alexander the Great may have been killed by strychnine from contaminated wine that he drank. Number 6. Arsenic. Arsenic is a metalloid that usually exists in combination with other metals and elements, although it can exist as a pure elemental crystal. Arsenic has many useful applications, such as being alloyed with lead to create components in automotive batteries and ammunition. It also happens to be a very toxic substance, so are used as components for pesticides and weed killers. And, like any other potent poison, arsenic is capable of causing serious harm and even death to men. What arsenic does to the body is attack the ATP enzymes, responsible for cellular energy production, and this in turn leads to vomiting, abdominal pain, and bloody diarrhea. A longer period of exposure will lead to worse symptoms, which include thickening and darkening of the skin, heart disease, cancer, and eventually death. The most common cause for arsenic exposure around the world is contamination of water supply, either naturally or the result of industrial and agricultural activity. Throughout the Middle Ages and in Renaissance Italy, arsenic poisoning was a favorable method for murder due to its symptoms that are difficult to distinguish from cholera, a rather common disease during those times. During Korea's Joseon era, a poison cocktail composed of arsenic was used as capital punishment for high-profile figures and members of royalty. Number 5, Mercury. It shouldn't be news that those shiny silvery liquids you find in thermometers are poisonous. Compounds of the chemical element mercury are highly lethal, even through skin contact. A chemist professor named Karen Wetterhahn died in 1997 due to accidental exposure to organic mercury during an experiment, even though it was only a few drops that spilt onto her latex-gloved hand. Toxicity of the metallic element is due to its ability to inhibit enzymes that restore the body's antioxidants. So, a victim of mercury poisoning would become highly vulnerable to oxidative damage, resulting in brain cell dysfunctions. In time, this would lead to dementia and ultimately death. The English phrase, mad as a hatter, is said to originate from reported cases of hat makers going insane after prolonged exposure to mercury, a substance that they used heavily in the hat-making trade. Qin Shi Huang, the first emperor of a unified China, died of mercury poisoning in 220 BC after repeatedly ingesting mercury pills that he ironically believed could prolong his life. Number 4. TETRODOTOXIN. Fugu is a rare and exotic Japanese pufferfish dish that is popular among thrill-seeking diners. The catch of tasting this delicious cuisine is that it might be your last meal if the chef makes the slightest mistake in preparing it. Pufferfish is one of several sea creatures that harbor a deadly substance called tetrodotoxin inside its organs. What the toxin does is selectively block sodium channels at nerve endings, causing muscle paralysis. A person unlucky enough to ingest it would suffer from general paralysis of the entire body and subsequent death from respiratory failure. Although completely paralyzed, the victim can sometimes remain conscious and lucid for hours, with nothing to do but wait for their impending death. Currently, there is no antidote for tetrodotoxin, and victims can only be managed through supportive therapy based on their symptoms. Japanese chefs require special training and a certified license to serve pufferfish fugu, as each of the creature's poisonous organs have to be removed thoroughly. However, mishaps still happen, and around 200 people get poisoned each year, with half of them not surviving. Still, the notorious dish remains a celebrated national cuisine in Japan. Number 3. Cyanide. Cyanide is probably one of the world's most well-known poisons and is capable of killing victims in a matter of minutes. Because of its efficacy, it is a popular and favorite killing tool by both real-life and fictional killers. Chemically speaking, cyanide is a carbon atom triple bonded to a nitrogen atom. What makes it such a fast killer is that it quickly binds to the mitochondria in living cells, which are basically the cell's power plant. This causes asphyxia at a cellular level, and death occurs fast as vital organs like the brain and heart get deprived of oxygen. It's true that some fruits and nuts contain cyanide, albeit at a very low level. Apple seeds, for example, would release cyanide once it reacts to our digestive enzymes, though it would require an entire bowl of seeds to reach a lethal dose. Still, it's a good idea to stay away from digesting any amount of apple seeds altogether. Applications of cyanide in real life include industrial uses in gold and silver mining, as well as pest control. During World War II, the Nazis used Zyklon B, a cyanide-based pesticide invented by the Germans as a chemical gas to kill millions of Jews during the Holocaust. Number 2. Sarin. In 1938, German scientists discovered an extremely toxic liquid while trying to create strong pesticides. It was a nerve agent of high potency that they named sarin, which was an acronym for the names of the discoverers. When the Second World War broke out the following year, the sarin formula was passed to the Nazi Army's chemical warfare section to be mass-produced. As a nerve gas, sarin was found to be 26 times more lethal than cyanide. Another thing that makes it so dangerous is the fact that it's physically undetectable, as it is both colorless and tasteless. Once inhaled, sarin acts at nerve synapses by inhibiting the breakdown of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, causing it to accumulate. The abundance of acetylcholine triggers an uncontrollable secretion of body fluids in the form of tears, runny nose, drooling, vomiting, defecation, and urination. Ultimately, the victim would go into a series of muscle spasms and suffocate to death. Due to its severe effects, the use of sarin in battle is considered a war crime by the International Court of Justice and was globally banned in 1993. Previously, the gas was famously used multiple times by Iraqi forces under Saddam Hussein's orders during their war against Iran in the 80s. In 1995, the Japanese doomsday cult Aum Shinrikyo conducted a series of domestic terrorism attacks in the Tokyo subway by releasing sarin gas, killing 12 people and harming hundreds of others. Number 1. The Botulinum Toxin. The most toxic substance known to man is probably the very same substance that is injected into people's faces to remove wrinkles. We are talking about Botox, or rather its unpurified form, known as botulinum toxin. Just 1 gram is enough to kill 14,000 people if swallowed, or 8.3 million if injected directly into the bloodstream. The deadly neurotoxin is produced by Clostridium botulinum bacteria. It causes botulism, a rather rare but serious illness mainly transmitted through contaminated canned food. What it specifically does is block the release of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine from nerve endings, causing a state of generalized paralysis due to impaired communications between muscles and nerve cells. This could be life-threatening, as all muscles could be affected, including the respiratory muscles responsible for our breathing. But as we know, botulinum is not without medical benefits. Extremely small and purified doses can be used to treat muscle spasms and excessive sweating, as well as used cosmetically to paralyze facial muscles that cause wrinkles. Quite recently, a new variation named botulinum toxin type H was discovered by scientists in 2013. This strain is considered ultra-lethal, capable of killing a person at a dose of just 2 nanograms. Since it is deemed so dangerous, its genetic sequence has been kept a secret until an antitoxin could be developed. 85-year-old Mary Spangler, Shay's sister, and one of the passengers in the car was killed in the accident. Shay was taken to the hospital in critical condition. Shortly after the crash, the two teenagers deleted the posts that incriminated them.